I think I like all types of movies. So yeah, I'm always up for that. Maybe I'll watch that after a stream today. Sounds good. Where are my glasses from? My glasses are actually from Amazon. They're just blue light glasses, so I don't get a headache while I'm working or streaming or anything, because I am looking at the screen to like read chat and stuff. So yeah, thank you, SNRLXZZZ. Thank you, Shanks, and best IRL. Best RL
for the follows. Welcome, welcome.
Michael Bay said, "Boom." Michael Bay machine go burr. Yeah, I like pretty much all types of movies. I think the one type of movie where I love and like I know a lot of people don't appreciate or just think aren't that great are horror movies. Those are definitely my shit. I love horror movies. It's like really rare for me to find people who will watch horror movies and like shows with me, because I know a lot of people just don't like the, you know, like I've had people call like a lot of them like cheap scares and stuff like that, but I enjoy it. I like it. Thank you, Just Bad Karma, for the follow. Welcome, welcome. I've never gotten a horror movie. I usually end up yelling at the dumb choices people make. I think a lot of like psychological horror is like definitely more my tune, but I could go for a good slasher like flick too. I think they're just funny at the end of the day. But like the really good horror films, I really do appreciate. Like A Quiet Place was really good for me. I think I just didn't like the ending. But I really like that one actually. Okay, so I'm just eyeballing how much garlic this is, but this looks like a decent amount for the mushrooms that we're gonna do. And then we're gonna bacon wrap the asparagus and then throw those in a pan as well. Do you like jump scare or psychological? I think I answered that. So my favorites are Japanese horror. Japanese horror is really good. I've been watching The Origins of Ju-on, I think, on Netflix. That one's really good, actually. Quiet Place was incredible. I like The Cat in the Woods, if that counts. Yeah, that one definitely counts. Cut up as much as you can until your ancestors tell you to stop. I just chop until the voice in my head is like, I think that's good. I think this is good. Fuck Ju-on, never again. Dude, I feel like you stopped watching right when it got good, but then it was like, I definitely couldn't sleep because I was like so anxious after watching it. It was like insane. Like, half of the nights I spent watching that, I was just like, I can't sleep. It's not even scary, it's just fucked up. I mean, I guess that's the scary part of it, right? Because it's like fucked up. Thank you, Town and City and Jason is on Fire for the follows. So we're gonna wash these mushrooms. I'm sorry if my sound gets bad while I run the sink. Actually, the way you're supposed to wash mushrooms, actually, is you take a wet cloth or a wet paper towel, and you're just supposed to kind of like brush off the dirt on them, because they're not actually supposed to be fully submerged in water. If you guys didn't know, now you do. That's how you're supposed to wash mushrooms. Yeah, Ju-on, when it first came out, was no bueno. My friends and I watched it at a haunted friend's house. That was fucked. Oh no, I feel like that's a terrible decision. It's like the time I watched Insidious at my house, and I have the exact same curtains from like the baby scene, like in my room. So I just didn't sleep in my room for like a week. My mom was like, what is wrong with you? But yeah. So basically you want to take a little paper towel and you're just gonna like wipe wherever you kind of see dirt. And then that's it. That's how you're supposed to clean mushrooms. Like, I swear. Ringu series is so good. Ooh, okay. I'm gonna have to bookmark that for later. Honestly, like, I don't know why. Like, I have so many new shows that I want to watch, and then, like, I keep rewatching old shows. I think it's because I have bad and terrible memory. Like, I remember if stuff is good or not, but I literally never remember plot synopsis. So, like, I can watch the same thing, like, more than once. And it's kind of crazy. But, yeah, that's just how my memory be. Going in and out, I guess. I just explained why I don't rinse them. You're actually not supposed to rinse mushrooms. It actually affects the mushroom texture and flavor. The actual way that you're supposed to clean mushrooms is you are supposed to use a damp, like, washcloth or towel, and then you're supposed to just towel off whatever dirt, whatever, like, you know, like, not super clean parts of the mushroom there are, and that's it. No one got time for that. I mean, maybe you don't have time for that, but I clearly have time for that right now, so, yeah, I mean, for me, food preparation is equally as important as cooking it, so, I mean, you will just have subpar mushrooms for the rest of your life, dude. So, it is what it is. Thank you, Peak Alex, thank you, Gucci Wallet, and thanks, Vince22Mighty, for the follows. Welcome, welcome. Yeah, I want to prepare my food as close as possible to the correct way, usually, because honestly, food just tastes better when you do it the right way. Professionals, you know, they get paid to research why food tastes the way it does and how to make it good, so I'm gonna follow that expert opinion. Thank you, Gopi, for the follow. Honestly, it doesn't take that much time. You're only wiping off minor impurities anyway, so most mushrooms should come pretty clean anyway. If anything, there are like a couple little dirt spots here and there. For the most part, the brown of the mushroom is the fact that the mushroom is brown. How many mushrooms is enough to feed 1, 2, 3, 4 people? So I'm gonna again eat all this shit. Imagine not liking mushrooms, KW. I don't know, I'm weird and not picky. I'm not picky as well. I don't know. I will pretty much eat everything at least once. There's like a very short list of food that I won't eat. Like very, very, very short. And even then, I will eat it on occasion, still. Like, I don't like, I don't like fake coconut, like, you know, like the artificial coconut they put on stuff, but I will literally still eat it, so. What about well-done steak? I mean, literally, like, if I have the choice to eat it, then I will eat not well-done steak. But if I don't have a choice, then I'll eat it anyway. I don't know. I'm just literally, like, I am particular about my food when I can be, but I'm not picky. Thank you, Mr. Voodoo. Thank you, Dante's LOL, for the follows. Thank you, Habes, for the follow. Is she sanding the mushroom? Okay, guys. Literally, the right way to clean mushroom before you prepare it is to use a wet washcloth and just wipe off the impurities of the mushroom, like any dirt, whatever, and that's it. You're not actually supposed to wash mushrooms because it actually ruins the integrity of the texture of mushrooms, by the way. Just saying. I will never try balut. Oh, I have definitely tried balut. It's like one of my favorite foods. It is so good. Well, then steak is just burger meat. Change my mind. True, that is factual, but I still eat my burgers medium rare, so I don't know. some mushrooms. Never knew that about mushrooms. The Shiny Wonder. Washing them makes the mushrooms soak up the water and become less good in the frying pan. Doing it like this is the correct way. Thank you. See, I like a good mushroom connoisseur. You know? So like I said, it does ruin the integrity of the texture of the mushroom. So you don't really want to do that. You're just eating shitty mushrooms. Or like you're subjecting yourself to that. Why would you subject yourself to that when you could just very easily, you know, clean them that way? Thank you, Machine Kuma and that Mad Bomber, for the follows. Welcome. Okay, I'm gonna take a little bowl so I can put the garlic in it for now. And then I'm gonna put the cloves in there too. They're pretty easily separatable. So what's your opinion on sous vide for steaks? I don't have a sous vide machine. I would love one. I've been like eyeing one on Amazon for a while. I think sous vide is a great way to get like the perfect kind of cook for your steak. But I just haven't tried it yet because I don't have one. So I'm sad, you know? Okay, so we're gonna do bacon wrapped asparagus. But I am going to cut off these like whiter ends on the bottom because they're a little bit tougher. So we're going to do that. I sous vide all my steaks, but my professional chef friends just laugh. Interesting. Is there a reason? Like you shouldn't sous vide your steaks? I've never done it before, so I just don't know. Posture check. I'm already standing up really straight. Thank you, Fox Bees and Vic Chen for the follows. Oh, well, I get great steaks regardless. I think it's that old guard chef mentality kind of thing. I see. I mean, everyone's really particular about the way they cook, actually. So, you know, I think like to each their own. This one's just the stem. Okay, so these are going to become bacon wrapped. Asparagus is a good green choice. Yes, they're really yummy actually. Hey Han, I'm doing good. How are you? Okay. So, I'm just gonna go ahead and open up my pack of bacon. I generally store bacon in a new bag in the fridge anyway, so I'm just gonna completely unwrap this one. Good to hear you're doing good. Bacon wrap, yes. Bacon wrap for sure. We're doing like a super keto-friendly meal, so do need to up the fat content on it a little bit. So we want to, you know, add a little easy fat where we can. So the garlic basting, the bacon wrapped asparagus, all of that good stuff. I'm trying to keep it a little bit healthy by doing a couple asparagus to each bacon. I'm gonna do about four. This looks like a good roll. Like we're not gonna individually wrap each asparagus in bacon. I think that's a little bit too much. So, just gonna go ahead wrap those babies up. I'm gonna put this in a pan or bake it. I don't know yet. All right. Thank you, Angry Little Boy and Ming Ming, for the follow. I'm sorry, I literally cannot read Korean, so I have no idea what that person said. Yeah. This bacon is very frozen. I wonder how this would taste. If only they could invent, like, Taste-O-Vision soon. That's what they need. This bacon is slightly frozen in the middle, so I'm struggling a little. Okay. I'm gonna do, I think, 4 to 5 to a roll is pretty good. All right, I'm still, I am USA? Yes, I am. Hey, first time here, never tried making a reverse seared steak before. So we already put the steak in the oven, so that's the first step. About 400 degrees for, I would say about 50 minutes. That's a good benchmark. Yeah, so that's the first part of making the reverse sear. And then the second part, I will show you once that comes out of the oven. At about, I want to say 5:15. All right, I'm still at work and have to go shoot some video. Have a great rest of your stream. Thanks for hanging out, Marvin. Okay. Bacon very frozen. Wow, that Mad Bomber. Thank you so much for the tier one subscription. Welcome, welcome. I really appreciate it. If we have any subs in the chat, can we get some liquid hype, please? Also, thank you, Crazy Pumpkin, Call Q for the follows. But yeah, thank you so much, the Mad Bomber. I really appreciate that sub. Oh boy. If only one day I could feed all my subs, that would be so cool. But unfortunately, one, we got coronavirus, and two, I don't know. I feel like some of my subs are not local. So, sad. Maybe one day when we hit a big goal, I will bake cookies again and I will send